Hey guys, this is ShadeGrey, your undead host with the most, your master of madness and your shogun of shadows, coming at you with another arcade version of TimeSpitters 2. Last time we finished up the minor league? That's what it's called, right? Amateur league. Now we're moving on to the honorary league. So essentially, the challenges get slightly harder. The Honorary League, and we're starting up today with a Maxis run? I don't know what that is. Oh, it's Gladiator challenges. I hate Gladiator challenges. Anyway, some of you may be wondering what Gladiator mode is. It's essentially the opposite of a virus. Instead of one person running around trying to infect a bunch of people, it's one person only being able to kill a bunch of people. So instead of recruiting, you're taking out. We are getting to play as... Wait, what? Which one? I forget. Undead... back at the hospital. Never mind, I'm not even gonna try and make sense of this. So, essentially what you wanna do is you wanna look for the strange aura around him to take him out. Becoming the Gladiator instant heal. Health back all the way up to first. This level, honestly, it choose different types of enemies to look out for. The gargoyles have slightly more resistance to your bullets, while the skeleton dude, crypt zombie guys, like, have no resistance to bullets. What I would suggest is the same thing I suggested to virus. You find a spot, and you put your back to it. The only way that the enemy can hit you is in one or possibly two directions. And you just go crazy with the gunfire. Of course, since you're a gladiator, you're not invincible as you can clearly see. However, you're about as close as time is literally possible. Especially when you have two zombie guns, it's just unfair in so many ways. Wait, did I open that? In business. Aw, what? No! Bad zombie! Give me my power up! Thank you! And no, I know I'm kind of making it seem like you instantly get two zombie guns with the Gladiator upgrade. But as far as I know, you don't. Stupid grenade launcher. Yeah. This one's time-based rather than score-based. One of these, or two of these are time-based, the other one's score-based. Making it a little more. What did the gargoyles start out with? Grenade launcher. Anyway, yeah, that's pretty much all I gotta say about this. You're running around trying to kill one guy so you can kill everybody else, and since everybody else is trying to kill you, and you're that one guy, it's kinda easy to pick this fine people. See, you don't wanna get into that situation where it is very vulnerable. Should have gone for whatever was under the stairs. And again, as I said in the virus run, this is probably the best spot because they've only got one dirt coming to them, and if not, you can easily adjust yourself. Technically, I probably could have hit out in the bathroom after I got 23 kills, but whatever. Premature with the gunfire. Whoa!
Asshole!
Okay, essentially what happened is I got the gold because I got more than 25 kills in 3 minutes. Now we're playing as the Jungle Queen, going after people in a level we haven't visited yet. Sorry guys, I am extremely tired, and I don't know why. It is the middle of the afternoon. Alright, essentially you have 4 different enemies you can take out. Which are the Lion, the Stone Golem, the Native, and the Chief. The Chief coming back in Future Perfect as a playable character, as well as the Lion, and I think the Stone Golem too, but I could be wrong about that. You want to make sure that you kill the Stone Golem whenever you see him, because if you do not kill the Stone Golem, he runs the risk of getting the, Gladiator. And if he does, you are never going to get it almost impossible to kill him. I know I've done it like 3 times now. I mean, seriously, that dude has an incredible amount of bullet resistance. And I've got 2 AK-47s. They're right, no, not AK-47s. Never mind. Aztec Chief, die. Oh, crap. The 6 shooters, we do not thank you. Oh, I got it back. Okay, maybe I'm full of crap. 3 more kills to go before I am just completely awesome. Okay, let's see. Hey, get back here. Nobody escapes death forever, my friend. That includes the giant stone golem thing. And we get yet another gold award for getting 15 kills hit before 3 minutes. Yeah, I know, these things are pretty easy, aren't they? I honestly, the next round of Gladiator challenges get stupidly hard. But, we unlocked another character, as we always do with these challenges. And we are moving on to... What is that? Ah. R109 Beta. Sounds like a video game beta, but whatever. The, you're essentially playing an R109 unit trying to take out the other R019 units. I know, it's crazy, right? I think this design was the prototype for a design in Future Perfect, but we'll get to that when we get to it. You're running around with a rocket launcher trying to find the dude who is, I'm not paying attention, I don't see a Gladiator match. What? Hey, you stole my power-up! This is annoying. Okay, what? No. See, now I have the homing rocket launcher, which means everyone's gonna die horrible, painful deaths. Provided that I'm not dumb enough to run straight rockets. Or stand too close to my god. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's my fail. Since I know my health is gonna regenerate, I don't bother staying away from my own rockets. Oh crap. Oh crap, somebody's got a homing rocket launcher. Alright, this round wasn't so bad. Nah, and I died as soon as I said that. Of course. Okay, so... it gets really hectic when the dude gets in here, because you're running into your own fire while trying to kill him. Or, somebody can be an asshole and shoot you from behind. Come here. Come here. What? Who's your rocket? That was my power-up. My power-up. There we go. Everything's right with the world. Now, you, Mr. Robot. Hey, why am I having so much trouble killing the one robot? Okay, these are the underground tunnels that I think I mentioned the last time we were here. You can use these to safely navigate the level. However, I wouldn't suggest it. Speed power up! Woo! Now my rockets are launched at twice the speed! Hey! I just passed you! Back here! A shotgun? How'd you get a shotgun in this level? Ow. Since there was no name, I think that was due to my own idiocy, but I could be wrong about that. And this is a very dumb idea, following the computers inside here. And we're walking. We're watching our power-up be stolen. How did you get it? You're all the way over there! And you're tiny! No, my friend, that is my homie rocket launch. Ah! Okay, that was mildly annoying, and I'm sorry if I'm quiet at the end of this, but, to be fair, this is probably the most boring out of the three, because there's no weapon changes. It's the same enemy that I've fought, like, I don't know, 100 times at the moment. Everybody looks the same, and I can't really tell who's killing me, so I can't go, darn you, you Aztec priest. I didn't kill him. I think I fired a shot. Maybe he killed himself, and I randomly got the power. Yeah, I think that's how it works. If you're the closest guy to the Gladiator, or one of the closest guys to the Gladiator, it'll randomly select who gets the Gladiator power-up. Sorry, my voice is starting to crack up. Hey, you can't be invisible and be the Gladiator. It just doesn't work. For various reasons. Hey, there's my dead body. 3, 1. Yay, I was the Gladiator at the end. And we get the bronze award. How amusing. Why did we need 40 kills? 40 kills? I mean, if I had time, sure, I could do that. But damn, 40? That's just crazy. Anyway, we unlocked the Gladiator arcade mode, and as you can see, 2 golds, 1 bronze. Next time, we will be going to the Elimination Series. That should be fun. Anyway, I have been ShadeGrey, your player for this evening, and this is me signing off.